Now, you are a woman, an African woman, establishing these huge projects in Africa's ICT sector. What are some of the challenges you faced along the way?
As an early startup, it was very difficult. I was much younger as well, right? So almost 10 years in Africa doing business. And so the ICT sector, especially large project procurement projects, were really male dominated. So there's always an issue of when you win a contract, you know, how did that person make it? You know, I mean, we still say that even with men, but when it comes to women, there's a perception of, you know, how did that person do it? So there's that issue of always women in business being taken seriously, even after you've demonstrated that you have done well in a project and commissioned it and moved on. So there's an element of competition. But with the younger generation, I think I expect much more better, because we grow together in colleges, we do joint projects, and we move on.
Well, are we seeing women competing for the leadership roles in the IT sector? And Sophia, I'd love to hear your take on this.
I would say getting the number of girls or ICT educated women from college is very, very difficult, but it's now very much improving, even in Kenya, and the marketing creativity that social media like Facebook and others bring, women tend to capitalize their strength on that, which is an entry point for women in technology, in my opinion, and I think it's great. But having the core understanding of the programming and the whole idea behind the infrastructure of how to build a technology project and so on, the numbers are very low from that perspective. And in leadership role, I think I would like personally to see a lot of women be, you know, finding a vision and based on technology projects and pursuing it. There is not a lot at the top, but there is a lot of, I see, in marketing and the creativity of women taking leadership roles.
What do you think has changed in the last 4 years now that we're seeing multinationals showing more interest, Sophia?
Well, the fact that multinationals are coming to Africa in general is a big plus. That means Africa is no longer a consumer, it's active participant as a partner in technology and economic development. So from that perspective, we're very glad to see, and we welcome partnership. And although Africans have produced some of the examples you gave, the technologies that we have here, I think in terms of implementation and consumerism and to expand globally, we need our partners. We cannot do it alone. So from that perspective, I'm very happy to see globals coming in.